If you want an update on my rolling project pan, then stick around. Hi there, it's Hélène, and yes, we are going to talk about these products and others that are in my rolling project pan. We're going to talk about weights, and we're going to talk about the difference from month to month. If you are not familiar with the rolling project pan, I bring products in. When I finish them or I get tired of them, they roll out, and I have this project just going on. It's beyond a year now, and it just keeps evolving as I make changes to it, either, as I said, by finishing products or just needing to roll them out for whatever reason. And I think I have 11 products total. We'll see if I'm right. I just want to go over them from least to most used or finished, because it's just more exciting that way. So let's go first off to a few products that I did not use. So three products that I did not use this time around, and this one I wasn't sure that I would, and I really focused on another set of samples that I was trying to finish, and these are the Laura Mercier Caviar Sticks. It was a set of three samples that I received, and they take forever to finish. And what I was doing was finishing another set of products that I was using as eye primer, and I'm intending to use these three as a base. There's one very shiny one, there's one that's more taupe, and one that is definitely black, which I could use as either a liner or a black base. So did not use this one, but it's on my radar screen. And I also did not use these two, and it is mostly because I am focusing on cream products right now because of the Partners in Cream project. I will put the latest video of that project right there, but I'll show you anyway. And they didn't have a ton of product in them. This is the Milk Chocolate Soleil and this is the Chocolate Soleil, both from Too Faced. And I do use them when I'm not focusing on cream products. And I think that as I get weary of using cream products, I'm probably going to dig into these for some fun. They started off at 2.5 grams and they are lasting a really long time. And of course, exacerbated by the fact that I have not used them in a couple months. But yeah, it's the reality. I just don't want to use them right now, but I'm not going to remove them from the project because there are no powder bronzers that I am using right now. So they might as well stay because these are the ones I want to finish. They're the older ones in my collection, small number of grams. I should be able to finish them when I start using them again. Next up is a product that I can only use when I need it, and that is a Root Touch-Up. I had tried to use this product in my brows, but it's too cool of a tone for my brows. It doesn't look that great, unless I guess I have more of a cool toned hair color, and I haven't, and I don't intend to either. So I thought I would have this finished for this update, but I just need one more cycle, I think, of needing some Root Touch-Up product to finish this. Because it's gone down quite a bit. I think you'll see it in the progress pictures that I have a lot less than I used to, which I'm very happy about. And I used a lot in this past month. I had some pretty important presentations and whatnot to do, so I was paying special attention to covering my gray. I have a lot of white hair right here. I have a little bit of a Cruella effect, and so in order for it not to be distracting, I use this a lot towards the end of the time. Shortly before I get it colored again, I'm using a lot. I would say it's about a week of time where I make very heavy use of this, but I'm not going to force myself to use it when I don't need to. I think that it would just be wasteful and kind of silly. And these sticks, these root cover-up sticks from Rita Hazen, are over $30 Canadian. So I want to use it properly and get my money's worth. So anyway, I think another month. But I said that last time, so who knows. Now the next one is one product, but it's in two containers. And this is the original container. It's the Aurora Rose Gold Highlighter Drops from Annabelle. And I repurposed this Cover FX container to house it. And you'll see that what I have in the container right now is about right here. It has a dropper, and I prefer using this dropper than this mechanism that really doesn't work, and this gives me just the right amount. Now, how I use this product is I blend it into my CC cream, which is right now the Smashbox SPF 30 CC cream in light. And I mix this in to give myself a little bit of a glow so that the foundation is, or CC cream is not too flat on me. And I really, really like the effect of this. And I was using beforehand the Cover FX drops. And when I ran out of that, I started using the Annabelle that I got for a ridiculously cheap price. They were clearing them out. And I think it was just a couple of bucks. It was just fantastic. So I'm happy that once my Cover FX was done, that I had a replacement product to keep giving me that kind of a glowy effect, despite the fact that I'm using a CC cream. Next up, I'm going to talk about a relatively new addition to this project. I wasn't sure why it wasn't in it, because I'm really focusing on using up this zero pencil because I want to go back to the perversion option from Urban Decay. And so I'm wearing this every day as a panning item. So why it's not in a panning project, I don't know. But here is where I am at. And I think that there's about this much in the pencil overall. So I don't have that much left. I would say I sharpen it probably 4 times a month. And I did just sharpen it today. I had to for use in the upper waterline. I don't want to scrape my retina with the edge here. So I do keep it sharp because it goes right up to my eyeball, it being in the waterline. I am okay with zero. It does have some transfer on the lower waterline when I do put it on. But I do prefer perversion, and so I'm looking forward to finishing this so I can go back to a pencil that I like more. And then I have 2 more of these waiting in the wings for when I finish my honeymoon with the next perversion pencil. So I do want to finish it. It's going to be a feather in my cap to finish it. And yeah, I use it. It's a daily item. Even on no makeup days, I still put it on my upper waterline. So yeah, we're gonna get there. We're gonna get there. Next up is a product that has been in the project for a bit now, and I am right here, and I can see it through because of the ring light, and you'll have to trust me on it. This is pretty much where it is right there, because I can see through. I really like it, but the reality is I have 4 of these Becca lip gloss toppers, and they're not going to last me for years. So I want to get through them this year because they are one of the older glosses in my collection. I really like it. This one is the Opal and Jade, and it has it's like blue and lime green micro glitter in it. And normally I would be wearing this color today to match my greenish chartreuse eye color, especially on the inner to center lid. But I'm also trying to pan this lipstick for my advent calendar project. I'll put the last video of that right there. And so it was a bit of a tie which one I used today. So I did start off the day with this, but for filming I thought with the red top I would go for a red lipstick. I thought I would be done with this one for this update, but it looks like it's going to be 1 more update. But I am using it religiously, and I'm making pretty darn good progress, which you will see in the weight changes for this product. Now, here are 2 sample containers I'm very excited to talk about in this rolling project pan. The first one is this Sephora brow product that I had depotted into a Sephora sample container. And I had depotted it because I just couldn't get to the product in the pencil type packaging that it came in, because I couldn't sharpen it anymore and there was still a lot of product in. So I was using a brow brush and dipping it into this wax and doing my brows. And I enjoy the product. I didn't have a problem with it, but I thought I would put it into this project because it was a lot more attractive to just crack another one open. And this kept me focused on this container. And I think if I didn't have the accountability of reporting back, that I probably would have just defaulted to the pencil, which I do have one started already, which I do use when I'm in a real hurry. But this project has kept me honest when I do have the time to use what was left in this container. I'm looking forward to cleaning it up and having it ready for something else that I'm panning. And speaking of containers, I have one more to talk to you about. And this one, everything is finished. And this was the sample that would not die. I had 3 eye primers in here. And you'll see that it is empty. There's not enough to make another use. Everything is bone dry. I had 3 things. I had the AQUA XL in M56, which was like a taupey chocolate brown. And I was using that on my outer lid as eye primer for looks where I was going to use deeper colors. It worked quite nicely, and I was trying to just use it up. AQUA XL lasts forever. I don't know how somebody would finish one of those containers unless they're using a deep one for eyeliner every day. I don't know how you could get through it. But I did as eye primer. And then there were 2 other ones in here, and the first one out of the 3 that I did finish was the original Urban Decay Primer Potion. That was easy because it's one of my favorite eye primers. I like the just matte, opaque, beigey, cream to beige color for eye primer, and that worked great, great. But the third product in here was the one that was the most challenging, and I think you'll be able to see it right in here at the top. It's kind of blingy, but it's very, very shiny. And I could only use it in the inner to about 1/3 of the lid if I was going to use shiny color over top. And it was just lasting forever, and I was just so sick of it, and I just kept using it. And finally, I have my trophy here of an empty container. There's nothing left, really. There's nothing that I could use to do another priming of one eye, never mind 2. And so I am very, very proud of having finished it, because every month I thought I would be done. And this sample container just kept going and going and going. And I was just so sick of it. Anyway, well, that is it. That is my progress for all the products in my rolling project pan. And I'm very happy to say that from 1 month to the next, I managed to go down by 3.6 grams of product. And that is not counting the change in containers. It is just strictly the product inside the containers. So this is truly 3.6 grams of product, period. So I'm really excited about that. I'm excited about taking these out, and you will see the new starting point for the project going forward. Okay, that's enough of me talking. Let's take a look at the progress pictures. So that is it. Two sample containers done. One more that is on its last legs. And hopefully a gloss that I will be able to declare victory over at the next update. I hope you enjoyed this update. Thank you so much for watching. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. But for now, take care.